Restolad here. Been on YouTube long enough, been holding out. It's time to show you guys what we do down here in New Zealand, or how we fix things. This is a Lambretta front mudguard. As you can see, it was a little bit buckled, dented, cracked. So I've metal finished one side this morning. Thought I'm holding out on everybody out there, I better show you how to do this. So what you do to start with,
bye Lexi.
What you do to start with is you get the shape of the guard right first. It could be anything, it could be a mud guard, could be your door, could be a roof skin you've unpicked, doesn't matter. So you get this into the right shape. So wherever it's buckled or collapsed in, you push or dress or off dolly that out. So you've got your original shape right first. No point going repairing the dent somewhere in the middle if it's all, the edges are all pushed out. So rule number one, align your edges. Next thing you do, you go through and you weld with a MIG weld or a TIG or whatever you, or gas, whatever your fetish is, and you weld up all your cracks, because where it's cracked is where the panel's going to flex. All right, that's number one, introduction to the mudguard. So I'll quickly fasten that to my bench with my G-clamp, and I'll take one of these dents out so you guys can see. Number two, tools. You've got to have the tools of the trade. I've been collecting these for 15 years. My dad was a panel beater before this, or a body shop man. So you need like flat face panel hammer, you need a return sweep panel hammer. Dead blow mallets are really handy for pushing and tapping things out. A wooden mallet is essential for aligning edges. Lots and lots of dollies. This is my favorite. It's called a comma dolly. That toolbox over there has a massive collection of dollies and hammers. So there's all these different dollies in here. Some of the best dollies are ones you can make. All right, this one's really excellent for going around a lot of the Vespa and Lambretta work, because it follows those edges and contours. This was bent and made exactly for that. Same with your hammers. The best hammer I own is, this is an old cobbler's or a shoemaker's hammer, but it's got this excellent angle and edge for tucking, and the square face, it used to be round. I cut it square with a disc grinder, and that's used for getting into along edges or swages, places like that. So you need lots of tools. If you've done it all before, you'll have some of them, maybe not all of them. So what we use here in New Zealand, let me introduce you to the slapstick. A slapstick is used for stretching out or lifting a dent up. Now, I've seen them use flat ones on YouTube, but not here. In New Zealand, what we use, for example, this is a Nicholson Brazilian made flat bastard file. What you do is you mark it out and you bend it, because this is one my dad made. You heat it up cherry red and you bend it so that it can be held and used as a slapping stick on an angle like that. The reason down here in the southern hemisphere we use an old file, A, it's tough and steel, and B, these little file serrations actually leave a mark on the panel so you know exactly where you're hitting. And that's your guide. Dent theory, before I hit it, number one, here's a panel. Any kind of panel. An impact comes, someone drives it into a tree or whatever, okay, and they put a dent in the panel. Alright, that material is now stretched. But the dent theory is this: when this goes down, it pushes up a high spot either side of the dent. If you don't know this before you start, you'll never get it right. If you just try and bring that dent straight up by driving back on the impact in exactly the opposite direction, you'll end up stretching the steel. The dotted line represents where it'll end up as it's overstretched and too big. You usually got to start with putting the dolly behind here and tapping those ridges down. Or, if you're a Kiwi bloke like me, you use your slapstick, because the slapstick achieves both. You can see the contact point. The slapstick, by me tapping or dropping that on top of the dent, I'm hitting down the high points either side of the dent, and with the dolly, my comma-shaped dolly behind it, with some gentle pressure pushing up, I'm also forcing that dent out as I'm pushing that down, and I'll show you right now how it works. So over here, you saw one side's all smooth and filed up, and the rest of this is quite bad and ugly. And I've got a little sanding board here, rather than my panel file to start with, so that you can see. Go around the other side, Libs, and they'll get light on it. If I just sand that with 36 grit paper, I there's your dent. That's your low spot. If you see how shiny that is, by the side of that, those ridges prove the theory that there is a high spot either side of that low spot. Now the beauty of the slapstick is that it will hit those down as it raises the dent. So you pick a dolly, doesn't matter what you're doing, what panel it is, you pick a dolly exactly the same shape or contour as the panel you're trying to repair. Comma dolly is my favourite because you usually get most with that, but yep, lots of others. That flatter part there I would use, as you can see, to raise the dent through this section of the panel. It's not as radiused, but I'll be using the more radius part here because you can see this is quite heavily radiused through here. So the dolly goes straight under here. This is years of practice and finding it and getting it right. Never ever hit it this way. If you hit it this way, you're just going to put dents and ripples all the way along that radius. You hit along the radius. And again, you reverse the damage. You start where it's probably lowest, not highest. You put your dolly under here, you do a little tap to find where your dolly is. Hear the ping, ping, ping? That's where the dolly is. It's right there in the middle of the dent. Now I'm happy, I'm starting at this end, and I'm going to bring it through this way. So hold on to your eardrums. Just gently dropping the slapstick down. See, with the file, using an old file, I'm leaving little serrated marks, so I know I've already brought that up. I've already raised it, because where I've stretched it, it's left those little indentations. There you go. I believe I've raised that dent sufficiently. What I'm going to do now, panel file, go along the radius, not this way because you're going to cut grooves into it, going to go along the length of the panel, and we're just going to run the file, a big flat panel file, smoothly over that. Getting bored, so I'm going to turn it around and pull it back towards me. Now this doesn't really cut. If you look, people go, ooh, you're making the panel thinner. A lot of that is just paint dust and just the finest and finest perhaps of panel steel or iron that I'm smoothing off the top. You see those little serrated marks are basically all gone. I have a low spot there and a low spot there that I'm coming back to raise. Again with a slapstick and my favourite dolly. And we'll be done. Look for where the dolly is. Ping, ping, ping. There it is, under the dent. Drop the slapstick. Look at that, right on the money. In that shaded painted part. And this little one here. It's just practice, you've got to be really patient. And there you go. Back out with my panel file, pulling towards me, because I just feel like doing it that way. Woo-hoo! Check it out, dent's gone. Might want to finish that with a 60 grit in your orbital sander, or we'll put some dioxidine on it or phosphoric acid, get it all ready for your painter. Like most of us, you probably are your own painter anyway. I'll just rub that over there to smooth the panel surface up. Check with your hand, because that's what the pros do. And that dent is gone. You saw that come up under the dolly and the slapstick. You saw me file it flat and smooth. That panel's now back in shape, so I've held out on you for too long, but there you go. If you're a resto guy, if you're into vintage cars, old Chevy trucks, old Ford pickups, motorbikes, Vespas, whatever it is, no polyester filler, no bog, and I've done that faster than bog would actually go off on the steel anyway. So give it a go. Make some tools, buy some tools, get an old panel, get an old mudguard, and have some fun at doing metal finishing. See ya.